Welcome back. In the first video of this three-part series, we went over the process of installing a PC emulator software. Then we configured our very own virtual vintage computer. So we are finally ready to set up Windows 95. For this, we need to open the browser. And we are going to search for an installation CD for Windows 95. But we should look for a bootable version of Windows 95, which will make our lives much easier during the installation process. This bootable version of Windows 95 is available on the website archive.org. And whoever uploaded this file was kind enough to also share two installation keys for Windows 95. They also made available here some drivers for sound card and video card, but the only thing that we need here is the installation CD for Windows 95. The download is going to take a while, so let's speed it up. Okay, now that the download is finished, we need to open the downloads folder and then cut the installation CD from the downloads folder and paste it inside of the CDs folder that we created inside of the PCM folder. So now that we have the installation CD, we can actually install Windows. So we need to start our Windows 95 PC emulator. It will show some BIOS information, but it's not going to start Windows because it's not installed yet. So let's load our bootable Windows 95 installation CD. And now we need to restart the computer. But before we can go any further, we need to make a little change on the BIOS. To get into the BIOS of your virtual machine, you need to press the Delete key as soon as the computer starts. This BIOS interface does not support the mouse, so we need to navigate using the keyboard arrows. So now we need to go down to the BIOS Features Setup and press Enter. Now go down to the Boot Sequence option, and if you look at the right bottom part of the screen, you will see that you will have to press Page Up or Page Down on your keyboard in order to modify the values. So I will keep pressing Page Down until I see the option CD-ROM, C, A. To go back to the previous screen, we need to press the Escape key. Now, using the keyboard arrows, navigate to the option Save and Exit Setup. Now press Enter, and then type Y and Enter to confirm the change. So now the PC will restart and load the bootable CD. Now press Enter to begin the installation. And here, the Windows 95 installation will partition your 100 MB virtual hard drive. Just press Enter to confirm. Press Enter again. Now Windows is formatting your new C drive. Press Enter again to finish setting up your hard drive. And now I'm going to give you an important information, so pay attention. Here, finally, you will begin to use the mouse inside of your PC emulator. But as soon as you click inside of the emulator window, your mouse arrow will get trapped inside of it. So in order for you to be able to move your mouse arrow outside of the emulator window, you will need to press the Ctrl key and the AND key on your keyboard. That key combination will make the PC emulator release the mouse arrow. If you forget this key combination, Ctrl AND, then you just need to look up on the title bar of PCem and you will see this key combination written there. Alternatively, you can press the middle button on your mouse. So let's get back to the installation. Here you can click on Continue. Click on Yes to the terms and conditions. Click on Next. Next. Let's go for typical installation. Click Next. Now to continue with the installation, we're gonna need the product identification number. So let's get out of the PC emulator. open the browser on the page where we downloaded the bootable Windows 95 installation CD. Down here we can see a valid product identification number. So let's drag the browser window down here, and that will allow us to see the number when we get back to the PC emulator. So now let's type that long number, and let's make sure that we got it right. Now click Next. Great, it worked. So now we can close the browser window. You can type your username here. Click Next. Now tick the checkbox for the sound, MIDI, or video capture card. Then click Next. Now click on Next. Next again. Now select the radio button option. No, I do not want a startup disk. And then click Next. Click Next one more time. The installation is going to take a while, so let's speed it up. Okay, now you need to remove the CD from the CD tray before we can restart the computer. So let's do that. Now we can proceed by clicking on the Finish button and click on the OK button. And here, since we are restarting, let's get back to the BIOS by pressing the Delete key and change again the booting sequence option, because we no longer need to boot from the CD, and this change will speed up booting time. Let's get back to the BIOS features setup option, go to the boot sequence option, and use the page down key to modify it to C only. Now press the escape key to go back to the previous screen. Now navigate to save and exit setup, press enter, Y, and enter again. Now the computer is booting again, but it's not going to boot into the CD anymore. It's going to go straight to the C drive, where we will continue the installation. It will prompt you for your time zone. I will select Eastern Time here. Now it will prompt you to install a printer, but I don't have any printer here, so I'll click on the Cancel button. Now click on the OK button to restart the computer again. That sound brings back memories. So let's make a couple of configuration changes to match our game requirements. Right-click on the desktop, go to Properties, and then go to the Settings tab. We're going to raise the color palette to 256 colors. And now we are going to raise our desktop area to 800 by 600 pixels. No, we don't want to specify our monitor, and I'll have to restart the computer again for the change to take effect. Now, let's do a little bit of upkeeping here. Having a bunch of icons on the desktop slows down the booting time. Okay, now that our Vintage PC emulation is ready, we're going to install a retro PC game that I absolutely love. The game's called Power Chess 98. Okay, it doesn't sound very exciting, but bear with me. If you stick around, I promise you, you won't regret. Now, let's go back to the browser. We're going to search for Power Chess 98 ISO download. And what do you know? The Internet Archive website has it also. Here, the Power Chess game has two CDs, one for the installation and one to play the game, so we need to download both of them. Here again, the downloads are going to take a while, so let's speed them up. Now that the downloads are done, we need to open the downloads folder and cut these two files and paste them into the CDs folder, which is located inside of the PCM folder. These two CD images are zipped, so we need to decompress the actual CD images into the CDs folder. And now that we have the actual CD images, we don't need the zip files anymore, so let's delete them. Okay, it's finally time to install PowerChess 98. And for this, we need to load the first installation CD. The CD will auto-start and we can begin the installation. Click on the first option there, Install. Click on Yes.
Your system is correctly configured for playing WAV files.
If you hear anything, you can click on Yes again. Now click on OK. Click on OK. And finally on the Continue button. Click on Yes. OK. OK again. Now click on Yes. Click on Yes again. No, you don't need to register the game. Finally, click on the Restart Now button. Let's now stop this welcome screen from showing. Now close this window, close this, and now let's delete another shortcut that appeared on the desktop again. I created this PC emulator to only play PowerChess 98, so I will make a little change on Windows 95 here, so that every time I start Windows 95, it will automatically start the game. For this, we need to go to the Start button, go to Programs, and click on Windows Explorer. Now here we are going to go to the Windows folder, then to the Start Menu folder, then to the Programs folder, and then to the Sierra folder. Now copy the PowerChess 98 shortcut. Now go to the Startup folder, and paste the PowerChess 98 shortcut here. Okay, now to do a test, we'll need to load the second PowerChess 98 CD. The CD will auto-start, so let's click on Exit for now, and restart Windows 95, just to make sure that everything that we just did works. Now, as soon as Windows 95 loads, it will go straight into the game. I'll skip the game intro for now.
It's your move.
Thanks for watching. The best way to support the channel is to like this video. And if you can afford, you could buy me a coffee. The link is in the description. On the next video, I will explain why I think that PowerChess 98 is still the best chess game out there. If you don't want to miss it, hit the subscribe button. See you then!